All right, so today we're going to use Google Sheets to create a task list. And when you check off the task, it's going to cross off the name of the task and it's going to resort your list and put it down at the bottom. All right, in previous videos, we've built task lists. We put this cool formatting on it, but then I had people ask if you can make it automatically sort. So they want the satisfaction of when you check something, it goes down to the bottom. And that's something you can't typically do in a spreadsheet. So I looked around the web, I found someone that had written a custom script, which we're going to use to enable this task list to sort itself. All right, so let's go through how to do that. First thing that we want to do is we want to get just kind of a cool visual effect on here. When you click on the status, it just strikes through the name of the task. So we're going to do that with conditional formatting. We will highlight the range that we want to apply it to. So that would be B2 to B8. We'll go over to the right. Conditional formatting rules are already up here. You will get those by going to format and then conditional formatting. And we'll come over here. We'll left click on add another rule. And the range of B2 to B8 is already in there because I had it highlighted when I came over to add the rule. And the rule that we're going to use, it defaults to is not empty, all right? So that's why these are green already, because they're not empty. So that rule is being applied, but we're going to change it. Come down to the bottom, choose custom formula is, and we get an empty box here to input our formula. If we look at the task list, what we want to do, we're going to write the custom formula as if we're in cell B2. So you always write the custom formula as if you're in the upper left-hand corner of the range that you want to format. So in B2, we want to cross this off if A2 is equal to true. All right, so a checkbox is just true or false. It's what's called a Boolean value. If it's unchecked, it's equal to false. If it's checked, it's equal to true. So let's come back to this box and we're going to say equal sign to start the formula. In conditional formatting, they're always an if statement. So you can say out loud, if, but you don't write it. So if A2 is equal to true. It applies the rule as you type. And if you come over, nothing's green anymore. Let's try it out. A2 is true. Okay, so we know the rule is firing right now. We want to customize the rule because green highlighting isn't really a good way to indicate something's done. I think a better way is probably for a strike through and maybe just make it a little gray in the back. So let's try that. Check A2's done. Yeah, that kind of makes it go away a little bit. Let's even turn the font kind of grayish. But not gray enough to blend in the background. All right, we'll try another one. Yeah, those look good, right? So now your task list is looking nice, but we want to add in the custom sorting, and that's where things get a little bit more involved. Let's click done to get rid of our conditional formatting. And typically with a spreadsheet, you can filter it and you can sort it all day long, but you have to actively do that. So what I mean is, let's go to data and create a filter on this. Give it a little bit more room. So you can sort on status, right? If I left click on this filter, sort A to Z, it's going to put the completed task at the bottom, but you have to do that every time. So what users were asking me is that, can you make it automatically sort? So when I was first getting those comments, I thought, no, you can't, but you can do it if you use a custom apps script is what it's called. So let's undo this filter with the undo button, and then we'll go to data and turn the filter off. And now to load in a script, we'll go to tools in the script editor. And that brings up this brave new world of an empty canvas, well, almost empty. We actually want to delete this here. I was not deleting that at first and it wasn't working. So it has this empty canvas and it's waiting for you to create custom rules. Let's title the project, we'll call it auto sort checklist. No, let's just call it auto sort. So you don't necessarily need a checklist to apply it to, or just something that auto sorts. And we'll go to this page on GitHub. I'll put the link in the description. I'm going to give credit to the person that wrote this. I will click the word raw just so I can do Control A to select everything and Control C to put it on my clipboard. And we'll come over to App Script and I will just paste it in. So Control V is how I would do that with a shortcut. So I've looked over this code. I sort of mostly understand it, but there are only three things that it's asking you. Okay, so up top is some preparation and it's asking you, hey, what column are we going to be sorting this on? So we want to sort it on the first column, right? Because we were looking at those checkboxes. And this is which direction it should sort. So think if we leave it on false, it's going to put the checkboxes at the bottom. And how many header rows are there? There's just one. So I think we have that all set. We will click save. The auto sort is the actual function and it gets triggered when you edit anything or when you open the sheet. Let's first hit the run button to make sure everything goes through okay. And it requires, glad I did that, it requires authorization to run. So we're going to review the permissions. My account's going to come up. I'm going to log into it and say, yep, that's fine. I gave it permissions. It actually asked me twice for some reason. So I went back and gave it permissions again. I reloaded the sheet and now let's click on it. All right, it gives it a second and then it sorts it. So actually, I probably want it to sort the other way. So we'll go back into it, the script editor. And it's easy, right? So it asks me what order. Ascending is false. We'll change ascending to true. Using this fancy pop-up box. Click save. And if I check on one again, it sorts them both down to the bottom. In this next video, we're going to look at a neat application of AppScript where you can sum or count cells based on whether or not they have a note. All right, so I'll see you inside that video. Thanks for coming by. It's nice to have you along.